Good evening. Good evening. Happy Mother's Day. Thank you. Same to me? Okay, thank you. Good evening and welcome to the 2018 graduation exercises for Edgecombe Community College. My name is Michael Jordan and I am the Vice President of Student Services here at the college. And I want to have a little chat with you if I could. Is that all right? Before we get to the main event, I'd like to play a little bit of commencement cop and cover some basic ground rules, if I could. First, I know you are proud of your graduate. I know you would like to clap and cheer when your graduate's name is called. Please don't. Commencement is a dignified ceremony, and we should act accordingly by showing reverence and respect for this formal occasion. After all the graduates' names have been called, and Dr. Lamb, our president, confers their degrees, you can celebrate by cheering, clapping, as much as you would like. You can even do a little praise dance if you like. Second, please remain in your seats to take photos and videos of your graduate. We have two professional photographers. Would y'all stand up? Two professional photographers. They've never been introduced before. How y'all doing? Two professional photographers who will get a close-up photo of each graduate after he or she walks across the stage. And you will have an opportunity to purchase as many copies as you like. Thirdly, please do not leave the ceremony early. Wait until the ceremony concludes and all graduates have left the auditorium before you leave. Fourth, so that others may enjoy the speaker and announcement of each graduate's, I love babies, but please take any crying babies outside. You may re-enter once your child is quiet. You will be allowed to come back in. Finally, if you would, take your cell phone out. Either cut it off or put it on vibrate. Thank you. Bathrooms are located on each side of the auditorium just beyond the stadium seats. An usher will be at the door and check your ticket stub for re-entry. The men's restroom is on this side and the women's restrooms are on this side, the right, on my right. Thank you for your cooperation and I would like to congratulate you and your graduates' accomplishments. Enjoy your evening. Thank you.
getting ready to begin our ceremony, again, we ask that you silence your cell phones, and we ask that you please stand for the presentation of the ECC flags and the entrance of our 2018 graduates. Please stand. Thank you.
us pray. Good evening. Eternal God, and in your will, our lives are lived. And by your wisdom, truth is found. We pray for these graduates who are finishing their courses of study and moving on to something new. Protect them, Lord, as they leave behind their current academic work to take new places in the world. Remind them daily of your love and care. Help them to stay true to their dreams, to use their gifts wisely, and to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love. Bless them, Lord, with the fruit of their labors, and make their lives a blessing to all. For it's in the name of Jesus Christ that we pray. Amen.
I want to welcome you to Edgecombe Community College's 2018 commencement exercises. Tonight, the college will graduate 439 students who will receive 536 curriculum degrees, diplomas, and certificates. 34 of these students will be recognized for completing adult high school equivalency and adult high school diplomas. What an accomplishment. You all have worked so hard to get here, and I'm glad to see you here. Before we go further, I'd like to recognize a few guests, special guests that we have. On the stage, we have our speaker this evening, Mr. Jim Rose, and trustee, Mr. Jerry Spruill, and other trustees that are in the audience, Mrs. Jessie Jones, Mrs. Barbara Campbell Davis, and Mr. Carl Warren. And also from our State House representative, Mr. Shelley Willingham. Thank you all for coming. Commencement is the highlight of the academic year. Graduates, I know you're ready to move on with your lives and do great things. Thank you for letting us share in your achievements. Family, friends, and special guests, let me also thank you for your support of these graduates and the college, and for your presence here this evening.
Mr. Rose, Dr. Price, Mr. Spruill, distinguished guests, trustees, graduates, faculty, staff, family, and friends. In 1985, the State Board of Community Colleges initiated the Excellence in Teaching Award. This program recognizes faculty who exemplify the highest standards of instruction. Edgecombe Community College has recognized teaching excellence since 1987. The college selects a teaching award winner who initiates an innovative teaching methods, interacts successfully with students, demonstrates leadership beyond the classroom, and exhibits unselfish devotion and significant contributions to the student, college, and system. Tonight, the Edgecombe Community College Foundation is pleased to recognize the 2018 Excellence in Teaching Award recipient. This instructor addresses her students early on as surgical technologists, helping them see themselves in their future role. She makes the content and skills she is teaching come alive through the use of patient simulations and real-world problems. Inside and outside the classroom, this instructor nurtures within her students a full appreciation for the needs of all people. She secured a local grant to help take her students on a medical mission trip to a third world country, enabling her students to attain a realistic perspective on healthcare issues faced by communities with few resources. This instructor holds a bachelor's degree in health services, a minor in business administration, and a certificate in surgical technology. She is currently completing coursework towards a master's degree in global health. She also serves on North Carolina State Board of Surgical Technologists and the State Board of Surgical Technology Educators, helping to strengthen the surgical technology profession statewide. Please join the foundation in saluting the 2018 Edgecombe Community College Excellence in Teaching Award winner, Susie Shippen Wagner. In 2001, the State Board of Community Colleges initiated the Staff Award. This program recognizes excellent performance and commitment to the community college mission by non-teaching staff. Edgecombe Community College has selected a Staff Award recipient based on the following: consistent excellent performance on the job, initiative, innovation, and leadership in the workplace, responsible, efficient use of time, money, technology, personnel, and other resources, attention to professional and personal development, and willingness to share time, time and expertise through service to the institution, its student, and the community. Tonight, the Edgecombe Community College Foundation is pleased to recognize the 2018 Staff Award recipient. This exceptional staff member exhibits a strong work ethic, enthusiasm, reliability, and a high degree of initiative and dedication to the job, the college, and our students. Fellow employees say this staff member is always willing to go that extra mile for her students, for our students. They also say that the word no does not exist in her vocabulary. This committed individual began as an administrative assistant on the Tarbor campus in the Fountain Building. She transferred to our Rocky Mount campus as administrative assistant for the Nash, Edgecombe, Wilson, and Halifax Nursing Consortium. When the nursing consortium was dissolved, this individual transitioned into her current position as administrative assistant for Allied Health. However, according to our staff, this individual has always supported multiple departments and has always helped with campus functions on the Rocky Mount campus. She assists students in registering for community continuing education classes, and she refers students to student services and student success centers as needed. Her desire to help students and fellow employees is evident. Please join the foundation in saluting 2018 Edgecombe Community College Staff Award winner, Kim Lucas.
Good evening again. Edgecombe Community College is very fortunate and privileged to have graduating class whose members have performed well academically while proving themselves to be outstanding leaders. Many of our graduates are worthy of special recognition. A special honor is bestowed upon the graduates with the highest grade point average from each of our three academic divisions. These individuals have the honor of carrying their divisional flag during the graduate march this evening. This year's honorees are Hannah Grace Webb, representing the Division of Arts and Sciences. Would you please stand? Gloria Jean Whitaker, representing the Division of Business, Industries, and Technologies. And Sequin Winstead, representing the Division of Health Sciences. We would like to recognize our EDGE scholars who are graduating tonight. The EDGE scholarship is the most prestigious scholarship awarded to students at Edgecombe Community College. The scholarship fully funds the education of qualified students and covers the cost of tuition, books, and fees for up to 3 years. Recipients must maintain a minimum GPA of 2.6 grade point average and remain in good standing with the college. We are very proud of our graduates who are EDGE scholars. They are Tony Cody, Kimberly Ann Laffery, Thomas Cole Sturgill, Gloria Jean Whitaker, and Sequin Winstead. Would you please stand? These students are wearing a gold medallion with a red ribbon signifying their accomplishments. We would like to recognize student ambassadors who are graduating tonight. The Edgecombe Community College Foundation sponsors the Student Ambassadors Program to reward academic excellence. These students help host campus activities and assist with registration and orientation. They are true ambassadors for the college. The following graduates served as ambassadors this year: Ruby Esteban, Sarah Tompkins, Quartisha Williams, and Sequin Winstead. Graduate Nicole Wainwright served as a student ambassador last year. Student ambassadors, would you please stand? The Dallas Herring Achievement Award was established to recognize students who embody the philosophy of the late Dallas Herring, the founder of the North Carolina Community College system. He said that community college should take people where they are and carry them as far as they can go. Ms. Yvonne Dickens is the Edgecombe Community College 2018 nominee for this award. Ms. Dickens has overcome many life challenges to be successful. At age 53, that's young, she entered our basic skills program to work toward her high school credential. She successfully completed her GED in 2013. In 2015, Ms. Dickens returned to Edgecombe Community College and enrolled in our Medical Office Administration program. She does not have access to internet at home, so she would work on computers in the college library to complete her assignments. She does not have transportation, so she would actually walk to campus. Despite these significant obstacles that will cause most of us to quit, Ms. Dickinson persevered. She has held a part-time job for the last 8 months, and her employer has been waiting for her to graduate so she can hire her full-time. She also provides care for three elderly individuals. Ms. Dickens continues to inspire us and motivate us to do better. Today, she graduates with a GPA average of 3.19 out of a possible 4.0. Ms. Dickens, would you please come forward? Each year, the North Carolina Community College honors 58 students for their academic achievements. Mr. Sequin Winstead is the 2018 North Carolina Community College Academic Excellence Award recipient from ECC. He graduates this evening with a medical assisting degree, an electronic health record certification, and a clinical assistance certificate. Mr. Winstead has taken advantage of every extracurricular leadership opportunity available to him. During this time here, he has been inducted into the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, selected as a student ambassador, elected as an officer in the Student Government Association, serving as curriculum representative, and nominated to attend President's Hour. Mr. Winstead says he came here to college for the college experience, to develop leadership skills, and to build his resume. We think he is well on his way. Mr. Winstead has obtained a GPA of 3.914. He will receive a certificate, a plaque, a medallion signifying his academic excellence. Mr. Winstead, would you please come forward? The Governor Robert Scott Student Leadership Award was established to recognize a student who has demonstrated exemplary leadership. Ms. Nicole Wainwright has excelled in this area. Ms. Wainwright is what we refer to as a non-traditional student. After being a stay-at-home mom for 10 years, she decided to pursue a degree in nursing at Edgecombe Community College. I don't know how she found the time, because nursing is a difficult and demanding program. But Ms. Wainwright has been very active in the life of the college. This year, she was president of the Student Nurses Association. Last year, she was vice president. She also was a student ambassador last year. She has been an officer in Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society for 2 years and currently serves as chapter president. Ms. Wainwright received a Regional Distinguished Officer Award last year. She was in charge of numerous and successful service projects sponsored by Phi Theta Kappa, including the Holiday Coat Drive and Adopt the Highway. She has earned a GPA of 3.388. Ms. Wainwright, would you please come forward? We are proud of Ms. Dickens, Mr. Winstead, and Ms. Wainwright, and we wish them great success in the future. You will see in the back of your program those students who have been selected for membership in Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society and who's who among students in American universities and colleges. At this time, would these students please stand? Let us recognize the Student Government Association officers. Our graduates who are officers are wearing a red satin stole that is embroidered with SGA officer in gold. Will all SGA officers please stand? Lastly, let us recognize our veterans who are graduating. They are wearing a double Americana cord that is red, white, and blue. Veterans, will you please stand? Thank you.
Gives me great pleasure to introduce our speaker for this evening. Mr. Jim Rose is regional president in the Raleigh market of United Community Bank. He is responsible for building the United platform for commercial lending in Raleigh and providing oversight of the bank's activities in the region. Mr. Rose has nearly 30 years of experience in banking, primarily in regional management and credit management for community banks. He began his career with BB&T in Wilson. Mr. Rose is vice chair of the State Board of Community Colleges. He also sits on the finance, legislative affairs, and policy committees of the State Board. He is a member of the Board of Directors of Delta Dental Insurance of North Carolina and the North Carolina Rural Center. In addition, he serves on the Board of Leadership Rocky Mount and is a graduate of the class of 21. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Jim Rose.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate Dr. Lamb's invitation to be here tonight. I was so excited, I shared it with my wife. I told her, I said, Dr. Lamb called and asked me to speak at Edgecombe Community College's graduation. I said, but she let it slip that a bigger name had a conflict and wasn't able to be here, and that I really wasn't her first choice. When I told my wife that, she said, look, don't let that hurt your feelings. You weren't my first choice either. So that's kind of how that started. And then my wife said, well, look, I'm going to give you some advice. She said, don't try to be charming or witty or funny. Just be yourself. And I said, well, I don't know that I'm going to put you up for any motivational speaking anytime soon. But no, I'm actually kidding on that. But I'm really excited to be here. The community college system really has my heart. I grew up in Kinston, North Carolina, not far from here. I didn't finish 11th grade. Dropped out of 11th grade, got my GED at the community college. 3.5 years, I graduated from Wake Forest University with honors in economics and had worked 32 hours a week as a student in addition to that. So why do I tell you that? I tell you that to say that this is just the beginning for all of you. There's so many things that you can do from here. Everybody here tonight believes in you and is excited about the future that you have. And I really just wanted to come and share one secret to success that I've found over the years. I remember at my college graduation, I didn't have a high school graduation, but I remember at my college graduation, the CEO of Pepsi at the time spoke, and I don't remember one word that he said. And what I would like tonight is if you could just take home one little morsel, one little nugget from this talk tonight of something you could apply, I would feel like I had done a decent job for you here tonight. So what, you know, there are a lot of great books on time management and goal setting and, you know, 7 habits of effective people, all those things. I'm really here to just give you one secret. This secret is so powerful that it can't be sold, it must be told. It's just got to be shared with you. This secret has great power, though. It has the power to change your life, and it's got the power to change other people's lives. The secret to success, in my opinion, in my 51 years of life, is to encourage other people. And that's what I'm here to do tonight, is to encourage you. You see, everybody in life has been through hard times. We're here tonight to celebrate, but there's not one person in here that hasn't dealt with loss, that hasn't dealt with pain, that hasn't dealt with health issues, and they might be going through it right now. And all we see is the pretty smile or what's on the outside, but we never know what somebody's going through on the inside. Everybody needs to be encouraged. It reminds me of a story. Two friends were at a concert, and they were enjoying what was going on. There was some guitar playing and drums and stuff up on stage. And the one guy nudged his buddy. He said, "Do you hear this couple back behind me?" He said, "Well, no, I really hadn't been paying attention. I'm kind of listening to what's going on up on the stage." And so they went back to listening. Well, now this guy has become aware of it. He hears the couple behind him talking. So finally, he's had enough of it, and he turned around. He said, "Sir, do y'all mind being quiet? And we paid a lot of money. We saved up for these tickets. This is our favorite guy. Could you just keep it down?" The guy said, "I am so sorry." He said, "We'll keep it down." He said, "You see, my wife is blind." And he said, "I'm trying to describe for her what's going up on stage." Well, of course, he felt horrible. And the moral of that story is that we just don't know what people are going through when they cut us off on the highway, when they're in a bad mood, whatever they do, we just don't know. We've got to encourage each other. I also heard the story of a husband and wife. They were at marriage counseling. They'd been married a long time. And one of the wife's chief complaints to the counselor is, she said, "My husband never tells me that he loves me." And he said, "Well, listen here. I told her I loved her on our wedding day, and if I ever changed my mind, I'd let her know." Anybody who's married knows it's not enough to just say it one time. You need continuous encouragement. You see, the Bible says, I was so glad to know we prayed tonight at the beginning of this to have God's blessing on this. But the Bible says in Proverbs, "Two are better than one, for when one falls, the other is there to lift him up." I want to be a lifter of the fallen. You see, the media tries to tell us that we're different. The politicians try to divide us and separate us. But my favorite comedian who passed, Bernie Mac, said, "We're different, but we're all the same." We're all the same. You see, I try to do all I can to avoid people that bring me down. It reminds me of a story of two friends, again, not the two at the concert. These are two different friends. Two friends who, one was really negative all the time, and the other one was very positive all the time. Well, the positive friend got a new hunting dog, and he called his negative buddy over and said, "Look, I want you to come over to my farm. I got a pond out back. I want to show you what my new hunting dog can do." So the negative friend says, "You know, I don't have time for this, but I guess I'll go. It's probably not going to be any good." So he gets over there. The positive guy brings his dog out. He takes a little retrieving toy. He throws it out halfway into the pond, and the dog walks on the water, gets the retrieving toy, walks back, lays it down at his owner's feet. The positive guy looked at his negative friend. He said, "What do you think about my dog?" He said, "I knew it was a waste of time coming here. That dog can't even swim." So we want to be with people that encourage us. I'm going to tell you one more thing about making sure that you always stay around encouraging people. Then I'm going to tell you two encouraging stories, and I'm going to be done. But I'm going to need this young man's help right here. He looks strong to me. Can you come up and help me? It's easy to be drugged down. It's hard to be pulled up. You need people to pull you up. It's just too easy. I'm gonna tell you two quick stories, and then I'm gonna sit down because I'm more excited about seeing all of you celebrate tonight than I am about hearing me talk. But I'm gonna tell you two quick stories. One happened in Wilson, not very far from here, and one happened in Raleigh, where I live. The first story is about a lady whose name is Kitty Mabry. And Kitty and I worked together when I was right out of college at BB&T in Wilson. This was way back a long, long time ago because I'm old. But this was about 30 years ago. And it was just at the time, y'all can't believe this, but it was just at the time when something had come out called Lotus Software. Lotus became Excel Software. Well, Kitty at the time reminded me of my grandmother. She had her hair teased up like Dolly Parton, lots of lipstick and makeup. She had worked at the bank for 45 years. And she had the biggest portfolio of customers in the whole bank. I was just a little wet behind the ears youngster that knew nothing. But computers were just starting to become really popular in the way that we did business at the bank. She thought about quitting because she just couldn't learn the computer. I said, well, I'm going to tell you something, Kitty. If you'll go out and keep getting clients and taking care of them, I'll do all your computer work because I know how to do it. I'll help you because I care about you and you remind me of my grandmother. So I did her work and my work. Didn't bother me. I had time to do it. And so her husband got MS. And she came in one Monday morning. She was really sad about it. And she said, I'm going to have to retire. But she went to our boss and she said, after 45 years, my customers are like family to me. I really don't want to leave them. She said, I'm going to retire, but you got to give me one wish. And he said, well, what's that? She said, I want to be able to say who gets all of my clients. She had the biggest, there were about eight of us bankers, and she was number one, and I was number nine, but there were only eight people, so I was really number eight. So she said, I want to give this one to this lady and give this one to this guy. And then she said, I want Jim to have all the rest. I didn't help her for that, but because I encouraged her, spoke words of life into her, lifted her up, all of a sudden my career got advanced 10 years easily just because I'd done a little bit extra for somebody that I didn't have to help, I wanted to help. So I'm going to close tonight and tell you one story. It's my favorite story, and it's a true story. My youngest, my daughter, is in second grade, and 2 years ago, or I guess 3 years ago, when she first started kindergarten, she and my wife are best friends. I mean, they did everything together, and so when she started kindergarten, my wife, her best buddy, her running mate, was now going to be in school every day from 8 to 3. So we went to that first day. We held it together the best we could, and then I get easily choked up. We went to a little coffee shop after we dropped her off at school, and you would have thought that she had gotten married and moved to Hawaii. I was saying, you've been the best mom in the world, and I can't believe what a great job you've done. And she's like, I mean, you think she's going to be okay? And we're like, yeah, she's going to be okay. So that school year went well. The next year is first grade, and my daughter talks even more than I do, which is a lot. It was a totally different set of circumstances. She walks in that hall. She's saying, hey, Mrs. Johnson, hey, Mrs. Davis. And she acts like she owns the place. She knew all the teachers. She knew all the kids. And so we didn't have that angst, that hurt that we'd had the year before. So when we got to her first grade teacher's door, there was this handsome little young man standing there with a Spider-Man book bag, and he looked lost. And I'm walking up to see my daughter Gabby's teacher, and the teacher's just got this look of horror on her face, and she said, this little boy, he doesn't know where to go. It's his first day here, and he's not been to orientation. He's got nobody here with him. Would you take him? I said, I mean, I sure would take him. I squatted down, and I said, what's your name, buddy? He said, my name's Cam. I said, I love your book bag. That's my favorite. I love Spider-Man. He said, let me show you something. He unzipped his bag. He got out his lunchbox. I said, I got two juice boxes today. Do you want one? I said, no, Cam. I love those juice. I said, my favorite juice, but I'm going to let you keep your book bag. Let's go. Have you ever been to this school before? No, sir. It's my first day. I know I got to get on the green bus. He had a little green wristband on. I said, well, do you know what grade you're in? You haven't been to orientation or anything? No, sir. I said, nobody's with you today? No, sir. I said, well, do you know what grade you're in? He said, I'm supposed to be in kindergarten. Do you know your teacher? No. I said, all right, well, let's go. So I grabbed him by the hand. We walked. The line for first day of kindergarten is about, there are three classes, about 80 people long, and we're the last in line because he didn't know where to go. And so I said, well, okay, buddy, this is it. He looked up at me, squeezed my hand. He said, "Will you stay with me?" I said, "Kim, I'll stay right here with you." I got down on my knees in my pretty suit like this that I like to take care of, and I did the knee walk all the way up. As fate would have it, his teacher was my daughter's teacher the year before. She looked at him first, and she looks up at me, and she goes, "What in the world are you doing here?" See, Cam had a much better tan than I got. I'm white and pale. And he was a beautiful young man. We didn't look like we went together. But I said, "Miss Davis, I don't know if you know it or not, but I want you to meet my Cam." And I got back down on my knees, and I hugged Cam. And I said, "My daughter is just down the hall, three classes over. If you need anything, you tell Miss Davis to get Gabby and Gabby's daddy, and he'll come look after you." I said, "You'll always have somebody here at this school as long as I'm around." And he gave me a hug. And that day, my wife and I walked. And this time, I had the same tears I'd had the year before, but these were tears of encouragement and hope coming out. So I just want you to know tonight that everybody here believes in you. Everybody's here because they're proud of you and of what you've done. Take it, build on it, encourage others, and you'll be very, very happy and very successful in life, because it doesn't cost anything else to be encouraging, but I promise you, it's addictive and it's contagious. I love you. God bless you.
Quanisha Deshay Avent, Associate in Arts. Kira Lakita Barrett, Associate in Arts. Alexis Rihanna Battle, Associate in Arts. Jasmine Nicole Bobbitt, Associate in Arts. Emily Grayson Brake, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Logan Burnett, Associate in Arts. Daniel Scott Cavanaugh, Associate in Arts. Brianna Cowan, Associate in Arts. Grant Davis, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Jacqueline Davis, Associate in Arts. Jacob Keith Driver, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science. Stephanie Ann Duffel, Associate in Arts. Arnell L. Ebron, Associate in Arts. Ruby Esteban, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science. Jacob Dylan Hyman, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science. Shantae M. Hyman, Associate in Arts. Carmen Nevada Johnson, Associate in Arts. Sarah Keeter, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science. Flora A. McKenzie, Associate in Arts. Brianna McKinney, Associate in Arts. Ryan Scott Mazell, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Jalen Demetrius Moore, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Trenise Brianna Moore, Associate in Arts. Colin N. Morris, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Thomas Robert Mosley, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science. Kelsey Tanner Owens, Associate in Arts. Heather A. Purnell, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Roman Kyle Poling, Associate in Arts. Beverly Shea Robertson, Associate in Arts. Michaela Rain Lau Roberts, Associate in Arts. Victoria Smith, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Stephanie Alexandria Stallings, Associate in Arts. Madison Strickland, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science. Sarah Elizabeth Tompkins, Associate in Arts, Associate in Science, Human Services Technology Certificate. Hannah Grace Webb, Associate in Arts and Associate in Science, Historic Preservation Technology Certificate. Alnikia Shanice Wheeler, Associate in Arts. Quatisha Williams, Associate in Arts, Associate in General Education. Troy Brennan Williams, Associate in Arts. Austin Wooten, Associate in Arts. Denise Arrington, Associate in General Education. Zachary A. Boswell, Associate in Science. Alina Guadalupe Cuevas, Associate in Science. Jasmine Dupree, Associate in Science. Jonte Harris, Associate in Science. Haley Nicole Keel, Associate in Science. Jessica Long, Associate in Science. Ryan Michael Picard, Associate in Science. Haley Michelle Summerlin, Associate in Science, Criminal Justice Technology Certificate. Darnell Harrison Jr., Criminal Justice Technology Degree. Katrina Diane Rayner, Criminal Justice Technology Degree. Deidre Renee Whitaker, Criminal Justice Technology Degree. Thomas Wayne Adcock, Early Childhood Education Degree. Yolanda Dene Bellamy, Early Childhood Education Degree. Ashley Danielle Cutler, Early Childhood Education Degree. Sarah Epps, Early Childhood Education Degree. Stacy Martinez Hernandez, Early Childhood Education Degree, School Age Education Degree. Brittany Lee Hopkins, Early Childhood Education Degree, School Age Education Degree. Brenda Johnson, Early Childhood Education Degree. Tashe Deandra Lloyd, early childhood education degree. Tammy Monique Norwood, early childhood education degree. Leslie Ann Perkins, early childhood education degree, school age education degree. Sarah Ann Person, early childhood education degree, school age education degree. Tanya Renee Williams, early childhood education degree. Jacqueline Smith Battle, human services technology degree, substance abuse certificate. Brooke Daniel Corbett, human services technology degree, substance abuse certificate. Jerome Dale Jr., human services degree technology. Teresa Ann Cowley, Denton, human services technology degree, substance abuse certificate. Tyria Redding Mercer, human services technology degree. Kanaja Nashe Pittman, human services technology degree, substance abuse certificate. Don Denise D. Silver, human services technology degree. Letitia Porter Bond, school age education degree. Rakivia Shante Harris, early childhood education certificate. Denautica Unique Massenburg, early childhood education certificate. Kimara McDougald, early childhood education certificate. LaShonda Deka Speller, early childhood education certificate. Brittany Marie Young, early childhood education certificate. Asia Barnes, school age education certificate. Brittany Renee Coggins, accounting degree. Kayla Green, accounting degree. Monique Yvette Sumler, accounting degree. Gloria Jean Whitaker, accounting degree. Maria S. Archer, Business Administration degree. Nathaniel Clayton, Business Administration degree, Business Leadership Certificate. Natasha Hinton Dickens, Business Administration degree. Dylan McKay Gardner, Business Administration degree. Stacy Marie Hedgepeth, Business Administration degree, Accounting Diploma, Business Leadership Certificate. Crystal Sade Robbins, Business Administration degree. Monica Kalisha Vinson, Business Administration degree, Business Leadership Certificate. Angela Dolores Williams, Business Administration degree. Innocence Imani Essence Williams, Business Administration degree, Business Leadership Certificate. Kane Wilson, Business Administration degree. Adolfo Angel Garcia Segura, Collision Repair and Refinishing Technology degree. Satchel Faraday Vaughn, Collision Repair and Refinishing Technology degree. Paula R. Stiles, Historic Preservation Technology degree. Joey Wayne Gentry, Manufacturing Technology degree. Marcus R. Hoskins, Manufacturing Technology degree. Ryan M. Worley, Manufacturing Technology degree. Tawana K. Burris, Medical Office Administration degree. Yvonne Dickens, Medical Office Administration degree. Tashe Vandell Noel, Medical Office Administration degree, Office Software Certificate. Desiree Patrick, Medical Office Administration degree, Medical Billing Certificate. Shantae Alana Rosper, Medical Office Administration degree, Medical Billing Certificate, Medical Office Coding Certificate. Kimberly Yvette Taylor, Medical Office Administration degree. Pleasant Nichelle Wiggins, Medical Office Administration degree. Christopher W. Smith, Network Management degree. Apollonia Edmonds, Office Administration degree. China Lene Lucas, Office Administration degree. Jonathan Diego Guevara, Software and Web Development degree. Brad Stephen Armstrong, Supply Chain Management degree, Business Leadership Certificate. Melanie Dolores Brewer, Automotive Systems Technology Diploma. James Cameron Carr, Automotive Systems Technology Diploma. Joseph Foley, Automotive Systems Technology Diploma. Christopher Ryan Thompson, Automotive Systems Technology Diploma. Patrick Barnes, Barbering Diploma. Kevin R. Darden, Barbering Diploma. Morgan Lynn Taylor, Business Administration Diploma. Marquise Lynn Knight, Collision Repair and Refinishing Technology Diploma. Gwanda LaFay Collins, Cosmetology Diploma. Kenyardi Rayshawn Conderi, Cosmetology Diploma. Monica Hutcherson, Cosmetology Diploma. Melva Jones, Cosmetology Diploma. Michaela Norville, Cosmetology Diploma. Tyasia Adore Sutton, Cosmetology Diploma. Kiera Worsley, Cosmetology Diploma. Merdeka Williams, Facility Maintenance Worker Diploma. Jarshalyn Arshe Manning, Business Leadership Certificate. Tylexis Daniels, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Crystal Denise Dickens, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Taylor Renee Murphy, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Cabrera Jamisha Parker, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Altisha Saltez Powell, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Mellicent C. Ramsey, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Tarisha Taylor, Aesthetics Technology Certificate. Shanika Deltrice Moore, Medical Billing Certificate, Medical Office Coding Certificate. Ebony Brown, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Catherine Ann Campbell, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Larissa Laverne Dickens, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Patricia Ann Garrett, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Kelly Diane Hardison, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Mary Battle Harrison, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Sharika N. McCollum, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Latoya Renee McDougald, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Lisa McKinnon, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Sherry Davida McLean, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Shantae Renee Mercer, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Tiffany Duke Paget, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Letitia Parker, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Sharonda Teal Petaway, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Lauren Ruffin, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Melissa A. Thagard, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Shanella Marie Thigpen, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Katrina Denise Williams, Health Information Technology Degree, Coding Diploma. Natasha Elise Adams, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Jamie Latrell Battle, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Yolanda Renee Pittman, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Tara Michelle Powell, Medical Assisting Degree, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Heather Nicole Pridgen, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Rebecca Lee Dean Taylor, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Lauren May Whitley, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Sequin Winstead, Medical Assisting Degree, Clinical Assistant Certificate, Electronic Health Record Certificate. Tanya Denise Acklin, Associate Degree Nursing. Amy Lynn Addington, Associate Degree Nursing. Angela Dowdy Barnes, Associate Degree Nursing. Brianna Batts, Associate Degree Nursing. Mona J. Brinkley, Associate Degree Nursing. Latoya Braswell Corey, Associate Degree Nursing. Brittany Dixon, Associate Degree Nursing. Brittany Lee Fields, Associate Degree Nursing. Eliud Kenandri, Associate Degree Nursing. Lakeisha S. Long, Associate Degree Nursing. Shantae Lene Mason, Associate Degree Nursing. Felicia Boone Morgan, Associate Degree Nursing. Amberly Matthews Morris, Associate Degree Nursing. Brianna Elizabeth Pasco, Associate Degree Nursing. Bianca Nicole Roberts, Associate Degree Nursing. Melanie Roundtree, Associate Degree Nursing. Tawanda Lakeisha Sledge, Associate Degree Nursing. Doris Elizabeth Taylor, Associate Degree Nursing. Nicole Thompson Wainwright, Associate Degree Nursing. Tyler Brantley, Radiography Degree. Christian Page House, Radiography Degree. Mandy Dew Hughes, Radiography Degree. Timoral R. Moore, Radiography Degree. Frederica A. Neal, Radiography Degree. Starla Lane Pruden, Radiography Degree. Taylor Brooke Riley, Radiography Degree. Shayla Najee Royster, Radiography Degree. Todd Staten, Radiography Degree. Brooke Lee Williams, Radiography Degree. Lorraine Bass Barnett, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Victoria Haley Bayshore, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Casey Michelle Dozier, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Kayla Renee Johns, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Tamika Lee Johnson Murphy, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Kayla Elizabeth Modlin, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Kendall Edwards Noel, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Asibi Oro Gano, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Lisa Marie Reitmeyer, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Recipient of 2018 Mallincroft Puritan Bennett Outstanding Respiratory Therapy Student Award. Amber Gray Stallings, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Robert Bradley Thalman, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Kristen Leanne Wilder, Respiratory Therapy Degree. Pamela Smith Barkley, Surgical Technology Degree. Bernice Braswell, Surgical Technology Degree. Amanda Jo Bridgers, Surgical Technology Degree. Racine Annette Cox, Surgical Technology degree. Kanish Forbes Walston, Surgical Technology degree. Rhonda A. King, Coding Diploma. Rachel Jean Alexander, Magnetic Resonance Imaging Diploma. Mary Elizabeth Brewer, Magnetic Resonance Imaging Diploma. Trevor Houston, Magnetic Resonance Imaging Diploma. Sabrina D. Johnson, Magnetic Resonance Imaging Diploma. John Rogers Jr., Adult High School Diploma. Christine Alston, High School Equivalency. Laquante Anderson, High School Equivalency. Shatanya Bellamy, High School Equivalency. Latoya Brown, High School Equivalency. Miguel Harrison, High School Equivalency. Jotika Jenkins, High School Equivalency. Antonio Mayo, High School Equivalency. Janet Pittman, High School Equivalency. Tanya Potter, High School Equivalency. Dr. Lamb, Dr. Price, and members of the Board of Trustees, I proudly present these candidates for degrees, diplomas, and certificates, and I certify that these candidates have completed their required courses of study.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Edgecombe Community College and the North Carolina State Board of Community Colleges, I do hereby declare these candidates for degrees, diplomas, and certificates as graduates of Edgecombe Community College. Graduates, you may turn your tassels.
Will everyone please stand? Will everyone please stand? Let us pray. May God's blessing follow you all as you find new journeys to travel. May you walk safely along the pathway of your dreams. May his gentle hand guide the decisions you will make and the passions that you follow. May your hearts and lives always reflect his love and truth. And may hope be a light within you that you carry into each new day. Lord, bless them now as they go into the new endeavors of life. Keep your loving arms all around them. Lean on them, Lord, that they may know that you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Bless them as they graduate and as they go forward in their new endeavors. We thank you and we give it all to you. In Jesus' name, amen.